All right, what is up, guys? So it is bright and early. Ella and I are gonna go get our car rental, and then gotta come back, finish packing, and we're gonna head to Palm Springs. It's gonna be an 8-hour drive, so we gotta buckle in.
Guys.
What up, guys? It's
back to the
channel tonight.
What up, guys?
We're currently walking.
We're on the Zin Ventures.
The road to Zins.
Yeah, that's all.
Let me talk.
What's up, guys? We're on Zin Ventures right now, trying to find the fucking Zin.
Yeah, this is why the price is gonna go up, right?
Well, we're not gonna. All right, guys, so it is the next day. Yesterday we got here super late. We left at 10 a.m. We got here at 10 p.m. So I didn't really want to film anything. We just kind of hopped in the jacuzzi. We ate, we relaxed, got some steps in because we were in a car for, well, how long? 12 hours?
Sherwin's, where Sherwin already has everything set up, is perfect for me. Thank you, shortcake.
No way. But, yeah, now we're, Elle and I are heading to the gym. We're heading to King's Gym, which is 35 minutes from our Airbnb. Unfortunately, we were talking to Morgan. We really wanted to change the day so we can enjoy our entire time here, but
He said no.
So now we're driving 35 minutes. We'll see. The gym looks pretty.
It's like an actual college gym. Okay, so
yeah.
It's nice.
So it's a nice gym, but we're gonna try to be quick. We have our primary squat session. Ella has an SPD, so we'll obviously still wanna hit the numbers we need for this, for what, this week two for you, Ella?
Mm-hmm.
For her week two, for my week two. But we're gonna try to pick up the pace because I'm waiting to get back, crack open a Corona, and chill near the pool. And then when I get back, I'll give you guys a house tour because the Airbnb is pretty nice. But see you guys at the gym. Yeah, see you guys at the gym.
There is a code.
They don't know me. All right, so just finished up with the gym. I'm going to do a little recap before I get to the house so I can avoid some clownage from the other folks there. Yeah. But pretty much, so as you guys saw, we went to King's Gym, which is literally like the only gym that's like...
Powerlifting.
Yeah, only powerlifting gym near the Airbnb. It was a 35-minute drive. And then, as you guys saw, it was a relatively small gym. Probably, what would you say, the size of the living room? Like an average size? I don't know. It was relatively small. But luckily, they had competition plates. Not exactly enough reds that I needed, but I was able to make do. Overall, the stuff on the wall was cool, like the flags. But the equipment was a little, let's say, a little rough.
It's good, like, if you're, like, just powerlifting shit, but, like, yeah.
The accessory is a little bit scary. That little leg press hack squat combo thing, like, it's a cool concept. Like, I would actually really love, like, a machine like that, but, like, that shit was not greased, though. It was not oiled up there. Like, I was out of the hole, like, I felt it just grinding against the metal, and then I didn't show this, but I did, like, two sets of quad extensions, and, like, it was plate loaded, and the plate was, like, sliding off every time I came up. So, that was a little rough, but if you...
I need your hand, bud.
Sorry. Oh, shit. By the way, Sean, if you're watching this, thank you for letting us use your car. Ella's dad, Mr. Greenshields, thank you for giving Ella insurance that covers her driving other vehicles. Otherwise, he would definitely would not have let us use it, but,
You act like my dad watches your shit, bro.
Yeah, he definitely does not. But, yeah, other than that, as far as the workout itself, I'll go first, then Ella, if you want to add anything about yours. As I was saying, so for squats were honestly rough, but this entire block, so these last, the deload, week one and week two, squats have just not been feeling good. My deload in my week one, my tech was feeling off. Today it was feeling a little bit better, but whether it's just... whether it's just, like, fatigue carrying over or also, like, the drive yesterday because we were in the car for so long, just there was no pop out the hole. As you guys could see, I kind of had to, like, you know, you guys probably know the feeling. When you're, like, fresh, when you're 100%, when your CNS is recovered, you can get some, like, explosiveness off the chest, out of the bottom of a squat. You know, it feels like you have power. But, nah, today it was... It felt like I was grinding through the reps. I think it was still around an RP 7, but it was definitely harder than I would have liked, especially considering that I've hit like 320, 705 for like a way faster double. But in moments like this, I think it's just important to remember that, especially when you're this close to the meet, all the fatigue from the last couple blocks are now going to start accumulating because you're progressively using heavier and heavier loads as you get closer to the meet. So naturally, your body's going to have trouble recovering to 100%. But with that in mind, if you're able... Oh, no, we have to take a detour. If you're able to still push through and hit... PRs or at least close to your top end strength while super fatigued, it's going to force your body, if you taper well, to overcompensate and essentially like reach that kind of next like 100%, 110% level, like your peak strength on meat day, which is what we want. So I think what I'm going to do is moving forward, I'm going to pull more back on my accessories, maybe take a few out, pull back on my secondary days just so I can come in a little bit more recovered from my last two squat sessions, because I have an RPE 8 single next week and RPE 8.5 after. And I want to hit around 345, which is my all-time PR in the gym. And then if I could hit it and move, make it move a little bit faster than when I originally hit it, or even hit like 10 keys under. All right, sorry. The road we used to get here was blocked off, so we had to reroute. But do you remember what I was saying? But yeah, if we can hit near that at higher fatigue levels, then ideally we can at least match the PR at minimum or potentially push it, because I do need my squat to, you know, at least be near peak strength to win. Because there's a guy, what's his name, like Dan, I think it's Daniel something, 120, who squats like 820. His deadlift is weak link. I think he only hit 640 in training. Well, it's still sweet. Anyways, but I think I'll have to get him there. But if I could get as close as possible on the squat and the bench, because he's a subtotal specialist. But
yeah.
Yeah. Other than that, bench felt good. I actually kind of undershot my top triple. Morgan changed up my programming this block. So instead of having dumbbell press on my tertiary, I still have dumbbell press for two sets, but then I have a set of three at a long pause before that, like 3 seconds on the chest. And I decided to undershoot a little bit just because I want to save my pecs and my triceps for the primary and for close grip, just because I know if I overshoot bench, fatigue ramps up really quickly for me. But I've been using a new cue, which I use today, which is pretty much pulling myself into position, into the arch before I unrack, before I would push with my feet. And I felt that when I unracked, I had to find my lats with the weight over me. But because of that, I was under the weight for longer, and I was kind of wasting energy doing that. So by pulling myself into position, my lats are engaged. And by the time I like unrack, I get right into position, and it creates like a real, really stable arch, more so than ever before, just because when I would do it before, right, I wasn't able to 100% feel or contract my lats. And so when I pressed off my chest, I kind of lost position. This way I can maintain position and just kind of keep everything stable during the rep. So if you guys have trouble with that, that's worth the try. I definitely like it. And then as we get closer, I'll keep using and getting better and better at it. Luckily, deadlifts are doing great this block. Conventional beltless, we got up to 540 or 245 kg.
Yeah. Glad you're having fun with deadlifts.
All right, brother, you had a good squat session, all right? Like, but yeah, so hopefully deadlifts will pick up. I'm hoping to, we're definitely going to PR and comp. The question is how close we're going to get to that 800, because that is where I can gain ground against my other competitors. Besides Chance. Chance is also pretty strong at deadlift, so we'll see how that goes. Matt, Ellie, you got anything you want to say about your session?
Deadlifts were ass. I couldn't lock out anything for shit, bro.
All right, but your bench and squats went well.
My squat was okay, because my hips are obviously tired from yesterday.
Yeah.
But my bench was fantastic. I haven't hit 80 kg for like a solid pause like that fast, so.
Yeah.
That was like a really good pause, so I'm really happy with that. Bench is coming back, but deadlifts are becoming the problem child again.
Well, that's one thing. When you do get, I was trying to tell her, and for you guys watching that, like typically, I feel like deadlifts are affected the most by the taper, but also affected the most by fatigue during
Margaritaville Resort. Oh, hell yeah.
All right, but they're affected the most by fatigue, just because, you know, obviously squat and deadlift are using very similar muscles, But I mean, obviously, depending on which one's your struggle lift, it might vary a little bit, which obviously for Ella, it seems like that's more for her fatiguing because she moves more weight. So it's okay. Hopefully the taper will save you.
Hopefully when I'm back and like using a power bar.
Yeah, that was the other thing. I don't.
Power bar.
You're sure it wasn't a power bar?
No, because it had the two rings and that's, it was wider.
Yeah, that's also why my squat was a problem, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, either way, moral of the story, if stuff's starting to get hard during prep, fatigue's starting to catch up, your lifts are not feeling the best, just stick through it. Trust your coach, trust the program, trust the process. Do not try to push it. If you need to pull back, pull back. Hopefully when you taper, when you unwind, if you stick to the program, come meet day, everything will fall into place. You just got to control as many variables as you can, which clearly we do not control very many variables. Clearly we do not control, too many variables driving down to Palm Springs, for spring break, but it is what it is. We'll be back, to Bab on Thursday, and then we'll lift at SoCal powerlifting for the next two sessions. But yeah, see you guys back at the house.
Get away from the house.
What up, guys? Yeah!
All right, guys, so it's the next day. When I got back, I forgot to record the house tour, but I want to show you guys just where we are, how the Airbnb and stuff. So here is the bedroom Ella and I are sleeping in. Ignore the mess. We come out here. That's the restroom. This is another bedroom. Another bedroom for my friends. And that's another bedroom for Ella's friends. We got a washer and dryer. And upstairs, kind of like a mini living room type beat with a foosball table. And you can see a little bit of the outside. And then you can kind of see the pool and jacuzzi. But yeah, so this is the second floor. Just random cabinets, shelves. Ignore the mess, but restroom and then living room, kitchen. Like I said, it was pretty dirty. We didn't clean after last night, but then here's easily the best part. We got the outdoor table, hacky sack, fireplace, and then pool and jacuzzi. But yeah, so basically today's the last day. Yesterday we were just kind of playing a few games. And then I think tonight the girls are gonna go off, do their own thing. We're gonna stay at the house, just chill. Basically who came were, like I said, Ella's friends from school, her like dorm mates when she was a freshman. And then my close friends from back home, Andy, Sherwin, Faraz, and then we had a couple friends yesterday come in and out. But yeah,
Heidi boys. So we are, this is 6 days post the last clip you guys just saw. We are on the way to Fisher, EDM artist, rave at San Francisco at the Cal Palace. I'm in my rave, a true fit. Ella is rave princess. I'll see you guys there.
Just lose time.
We'll be right back.
Fisher blue balled us. He should have got another 15 minutes.
He should have had another 15 minutes. He didn't do it to us.
End up being Fisher, bro.
Christ!